Casey, that's your turn.
Good morning. Man caves
are good, but man, that's
if you are in the lobby, we're going to get started. My name is Lee, and together with the band, we're going to lead you in about 15 to 20 minutes of singing track this morning. So if you're already in here, stand up for a song. After that, let your body in. Just feel comfortable worshiping and let your body in for us. Thank you.
Be my love. Wake me from my sleep, faithful one. All my life for you. Every single day. All my love for you.
Is not this the kind of fasting I have chosen? To loose the chains of injustice and untie the cords of the yoke, to set the oppressed free and break every yoke? Is it not to share your food with the hungry and to provide the poor wanderer with shelter? When you see the naked, to clothe him and not to turn away from your own flesh and blood. Then your light will break forth like the dawn and your healing will quickly appear. Then your righteousness will go before you and the glory of the Lord will be your rear guard. Then you will call and the Lord will answer. You will cry for help and he will say, "Here am I." If you do away with the yoke of oppression, with a pointing finger and malicious talk, and if you spend yourselves in behalf of the hungry and satisfy the needs of the oppressed, then your light will rise in the darkness and your night will become like the noonday. The Lord will guide you always. He will satisfy your needs in a sun-scorched land and will strengthen your frame. You will be like a well-watered garden, like a spring whose waters never fail. Your people will rebuild the ancient ruins and will raise up the age-old foundations. You will be called repairer of broken walls, restorer of streets with dwellings. Heavenly Father, we just praise you that you do restore our lives, the lives of those around us. You are in the building business. We thank you, Lord, that as we follow your commands, we follow close to you and know your heart, we will always be in the place where you will be building up, even right here. Thank you, Lord.
As we continue our worship, we'll receive your tithes and offerings at the end of service. Good morning. My name is Al Galecki. Welcome. Welcome. Welcome, Pat. Hey, I'd especially like to welcome you if you're here for the first time. If you're here for the first time, we have a gift bag that we'd like to give to you. You can pick it up on the low-lying bookcase behind our soundboard. We've got a CD of professionally produced music of the type you just listened to, as well as information about our church. And there's even some candy in there. So if you're here for the first time, feel free to pick that up. It's our way of saying thank you, and we're glad you're here. So when you walked in this morning, you should have received the program. Our program is a way of letting you know what's going on here at the church, our service times, some different things about us. Do we have a video announcement for the birthday, for the birthday planning meeting?
No, just have a slide.
No video.
Just a slide.
So, we have a slide. Oh, that's great. So, we have a brainstorming planning meeting for our birthday party, which is coming up in the fall. So, if you've got some ideas that you'd like to share with the church in terms of how we can have a great birthday party, okay, come on out 7 o'clock this Wednesday, all right, and help plan that. We've also got something coming up called Alpha, and I'd like to turn the microphone over to Chris Otis here. He's going to tell you more about that.
Thanks, Al. Good morning, everybody. I'm Chris Otis, and I facilitate and run the Alpha group here at our church, which is offered twice a year. And we have a new Alpha coming up on September 19th, and we do it out of the Case Mansion. Alpha is the first letter in the Greek alphabet. So I want you to think that Alpha is about the first understandings of the Christian faith. We go over a 10-week period. We get together and we talk about things like, who is Jesus and why did he die? Can I be forgiven for the things that I've done? And what's the whole point of the church? How do I pray? You know, if you are just in a seeking mode, this is an awesome opportunity for you to come with all your questions. There'll be no judgment, but just a really loving community that's surrounding you to help you process your journey. And maybe you know the Lord, but there's a lot of gaps in your own understanding. You're more than welcome to come out too and take the adventure walk with us over the next 10 weeks. I want to encourage you to know that it's only going to be offered twice a year, so the next opportunity would be the spring. And if you want to take advantage of it now, I really encourage you, anybody in your circle that you know are seeking, but maybe you don't feel comfortable sharing your faith or you don't feel comfortable explaining things, bring them out. It's for everybody. And it's designed to really help you build up a community of friends and to enjoy fellowship as well. We start off with a beautiful dinner that's free of charge, and then we go from there to a teaching and a small group discussion, and then we dismiss. So I really hope that you mark your calendars and you'll be thinking about who you could bring in your life that really could use some support and some help in processing your questions. And I hope program should have been this connection card. If you're a regular here, you know what to do. Just pull that out and start filling it out. If you're newer here, if you want to just give us as much information as you feel comfortable on the front, you may want to check off if you're here for the first or second time, because we have a gift that we'd like to send to you in the mail. On the back of the connection card is a place where you can put down prayer requests, questions and comments that you may have, about our church. So give us a second to get set up on.